Today's morning devotional. Our merciful and faithful high priest. Neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. Hebrews chapter 9 verse 12. As the sin-bearer, and priest, and representative of man before God, he entered into the life of humanity, bearing our flesh and blood. The life is in the living, vital current of blood, which blood was given for the life of the world. Christ made a full atonement, giving his life as a ransom for us. He was born without a taint of sin, but came into the world in like manner as the human family. He did not have a mere semblance of a body, but he took human nature, participating in the life of humanity. Jesus Christ laid off his royal robe, his kingly crown, and clothed his divinity with humanity, in order to become a substitute and surety for humanity, that dying in humanity he might by his death destroy him who had the power of death. He could not have done this as God, but by coming as man Christ could die. By death he overcame death. The death of Christ bore to the death him who had the power of death, and opened the gates of the tomb for all who receive him as their personal Saviour. Christ proclaimed over the rent sepulchre of Joseph, "I am the resurrection, and the life." He, the world's Redeemer, has bruised the serpent's head, depriving him of all power ever to make men feel his scorpion sting, for he has brought life and immortality to light. The gates of eternal life are thrown open to all who believe on Jesus Christ. In dying, Jesus has made it impossible for those who believe on him to die eternally. Christ lived and died as a man, that he might be God both of the living and of the dead. It was to make it impossible for men to lose eternal life if they believe on him. The life of men and women is precious in the sight of God, for Christ has purchased that life by being executed in their stead. Thus he made it possible for us to attain to immortality. In Christ were united the divine and the human, the creator and the creature. The nature of God, whose law had been transgressed, and the nature of Adam, the transgressor, meet in Jesus, the Son of God, and the Son of Man. And having with his own blood paid the price of redemption, having passed through man's experience, having in man's behalf met and conquered temptation, having, though himself sinless, borne the shame and guilt and burden of sin, he becomes man's advocate and intercessor. What an assurance here to the tempted and struggling soul, what an assurance to the witnessing universe, that Christ will be a merciful and faithful high priest.